Dear guests, welcome to this screening of Cinema, a Public Affair by Tatjana Wandrup. The film is about a dear friend of ours, Naum Kleiman, and we're not only here to see a documentary on his work and his life and his use in cinema, we're also here to honor him for his outstanding contributions to the world of cinema and to the Berlinale in general. Welcome, Naum Kleiman, and we have an award ceremony, the Golden Camera, the Berlinale Camera, I'm sorry, the Berlinale Camera. Yeah. My dear Dieter, I think we are making the same mistake from time to time. I'm really sorry. Berlinale Camera for Naum Kleiman. I'm asking Alberto Barbera, the head of the Venice Film Festival, on the stage to give the honorary speech for Naum Kleiman. Welcome.
The first time I went to Moscow, it was 1989. It was one of my first trips abroad, covering my new position as the director of the Torino Film Festival. Without knowing anybody there, I easily got lost in the ugly and huge Rossiya Hotel. Then, luckily, I came across a person who saved me and gave me a different perspective in life. This person was Naum Kleiman. It was the second day of the Moscow Film Festival, and he gathered me and some other foreign guests into a screening room to introduce us to the debut film of a young Kazakh filmmaker, became quite famous after following that. From that moment on, Naum Kleiman to me and thousands of people like me has been like Virgil, the most authoritative, gentle, essential, and helpful guide that a film lover could rely on in order to be introduced to the deepest secrets and the beauty of the Russian film culture. What he has done as a director of the only existing film museum in Russia is beyond any possible appreciation. If one was ever to pick up an idea archive director, that would be Naum Kleiman without any doubts. What he has accomplished for the benefit of the preservation, the dissemination, the research about Russian film history is beyond comparison. What he has done to introduce the most important filmmakers from all over the world to the Russian audience is simply impressive. In the eyes of the world, he is the perfect example of what a film scholar, a film archivist, a film critic, and a film lover should be. When recently, following the story that you will see in the film, a journalist referred to him as a legend, he was not exaggerating. It was simply a film in reality. My admiration for Naum is equal to my gratitude because I've learned a lot from him. One of the most impressive initiatives he took was caused by his reaction to the Bezan massacre when a group of terrorists held as hostage 100-200 pupils and teachers in a school. You remember it was 1904. At that point in time, Naum had the beautiful idea to create a film library for the surviving kids of the city, made with prints coming from other accounts in the world. I think there is no better way to describe his attitude towards cinema and life than the words written by Naum himself in the open letter of his resignation from his own museum last November, when he was forced to do that because of some horrible political decision. Let me quote it. "Love is much more powerful than self-interest and suspicion, pettiness and vengeance, thirst for power and brute force. We have learned this from the cinema, whose treasures, we are sure, must be preserved for the future and shown to the present. This is the lesson we learned from Naum Kleiman, and the reason why I think he deserved the Berlinale Camera more than anyone else. Thank you, Naum."
And
me on stage.
Meine Damen und Herren, ich glaube, jetzt noch zwei, drei Worte sagen. Der Unterschied zwischen der Berlinale Kamera und der Golden Kamera ist der, dass wir die nicht haben. Diese Berlinale Kamera ist eine wirkliche Kamera von einem Juwelier, Herrn Hornemann, und das sind 158 Teile und die sind genau nachgebaut von einer Kamera. Und man kann sie bewegen und ja, ich sage das jedes Mal, weil ich eigentlich sonst gar nichts hier zu sagen habe, Naum. Bitte.
Thank you, Berlinale. This is much more than gold the camera. What is gold? Thank you, Berlin. Because Berlinale is a spirit of this Berliner love to cinema. I was so impressed many years ago, and every year I am impressed with this love. It means thank you, Berlin, Berliner spectators, to support cinema. We need you. Berlin became much more than one of the most important places in the world for cinema. It's a very good education. It's very good education for all of us to understand ourselves, to understand our past. To be not afraid from the past, to be ready to change yourself and the life around you. I think Berlin is one of the most successful examples for that. I'm sure, with all difficulties we have at this time. I'm very thankful to my friends all over the world because they might, maybe don't know what they were for all of us after the fall of the wall. This is important for Berlin. You know, it's a very strange situation when you understand some of this. You are in a new era and you have to understand your new role in this new time with all difficulties what brings this new era. And we know how important is the support we got from all filmmakers from the world. And you, my dear Alberto, and Italian, what Italy made for us, and Britain, and Germany, and in Africa. We got a lot of support, voices from unknown people, not only famous filmmakers, like Tilda Swinton, or Tarantino, or a lot of German filmmakers, the best from Wim Wenders, Werner Herzog, etc. But from the normal people all over the world. So it means that this Berliner Camera is not my personal award, it's the award of the Cinema Museum. Thank you.
Und einen haben wir jetzt zwar nicht vergessen, aber einen wollen wir auch noch erwähnen, der dich garantiert auch unterstützt hätte mit einem Brief, wenn er nicht am 11. Februar 1948 gestorben wäre. Und das ist dein Freund Eisenstein. Ja? Viele Grüße von ihm.